Okay, after being 1 month away from the temple and everybody happy to be home again. So I think the best way to learn is questioning. Questioning about life, questioning about yourself. Questioning is the best way to learn. This is my own experience. So if you are not questioning, you just become, what is the word I can use?
Automaton.
Hmm?
Automaton.
What does that mean?
It's just somebody who works, does the same thing over.
Yes, exactly. That's what I'm looking for. You know, keep doing the same thing. No progress. You are the same stupid decisions we are making every day, and very sorry to say that. And so that's what we are doing. So questioning is the best way to learn and cultivate and develop our own mind. So I want to ask a question. When you come to the temple for meditation, what is the purpose? I'm asking.
It's my belief that environment is stronger than willpower.
Okay, very good.
When we meet together, each one's efforts will help the other to become more calm.
Okay.
More
peaceful. Okay. Okay. Anybody else?
I feel like I learned something.
Okay.
And if I was at home by myself, I wouldn't be as motivated to seek it out.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, it's helping. Anybody else? Okay, that's a good one too, right? So, I totally understand. So, recently, I'm traveling a lot, you know, back and forth out of country. So, I was questioning myself, and also I'm questioning about the people's practice. Now, this whole practice, meditation, yoga, all whatever people call the spirituality. Spiritual practice becomes so trendy. You know, everybody, oh, spiritual. Oh, so peaceful. Yoga, retreats. People are very excited. It's become like a very fashionable thing for people to do. But I can see sometimes the result is the same person. There's no big difference. So then I saw, as a spirituality, many people go to many different events, especially in this country. So then they go to the art exhibitions. So maybe you can go and looking at the nature. Whatever other events you go, different seminars, different workshops. So people go and participate, and then they call themselves, my life is now drawing into spiritual practice. That's what people say. But I don't see big difference. But I can see going to those events, those are wonderful things, please do. But I can see many people what they are doing when go to those events, whatever problem they have in their life, they hide inside them. Make sense? Right? They go to those events. Why people go to those events? To fulfill something. They have some issue, emptiness or whatever it is, the word you use. They want to fill that empty space. Then having that empty or distracted place, you go to those different events, including meditation. So then you go there and do and participate. What people are doing most of the time, whatever problem they have inside, they hide that problem inside that event. I hope everybody get it. So, in that moment when you hide it, you feel better. Then you feel, oh my God, this event is so enlightened, so peaceful. I feel so peaceful. I never had such a good experience. I think this is, you know, little fantasy. Sorry, you know.
Well, let's look at a different point of it, or the other side of the coin. Sports events. Why do we go to sports events? We like to see excellence.
Mm-hmm.
If it's a basketball player who makes a fantastic shot, or it's a quarterback that throws a winning touchdown.
Mm-hmm.
We look for excellence in each other.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where the sporting events become so popular.
Right. So whatever events, people are going for the different purposes. But now I'm talking about the people label the events called the spiritual events. Okay, spiritual events. So after people go there, they are having little fun, enjoying it, call it so peaceful, so relaxed, so fun. And then after they enjoy that, what they are keep doing? Keep going. So I know those kind of people. Maybe this is my judgment, which is totally fine. Why I'm judging? I want to help people. So I want to help myself too. So then they are keep going to those events and keep hiding. I met couple of people do those kind of things, but I realize I know these people many years, still their problem is the same. So now what I'm asking you, come into the temple. If you are hiding your problem under this cushion, in front of the Buddha, or under the table, or under the altar, doesn't work. You know, I'm very sorry to say that. That means coming to this place and going somewhere else, there's no big difference. But here when you come, because we set up everything so peaceful, Buddha is in front of, you know, lighting incense and candles and make it beautiful. This is not real, this is conditioned. So every event we do in the world, those kind of events, those are conditioned events. According to the customer, we make the preparation. According to the customer. So what I'm asking, if you are my customer, you have to be mindful. Don't get into the trap. If I lay the trap, don't get into it. So, if you get into that trap, you cannot get out after this. So, I'm so happy to say these things because only intention I have for you, I want to see you are doing well. Now people go to the temples or the meditation retreat to be peaceful. Why you go to looking for the peace? Because you know the pain. Now what people are doing, looking for the peace, having pain, that experience, then they come to peace, then they go back to pain. I call the bouncing back and forth. No, they are not, that's why I said they are hiding it. They are bouncing back and forth with this pain and you know, the peace, whatever you, the word you use. So, then the problem exists same. What I am asking you today, without getting to the root of this matter, you cannot find whatever you want. Now think about, you know, when you are studying and practicing, we are using lots of Sanskrit and Pali word. Now some Sanskrit and Pali word almost become like English words. Like yoga is not English word. Now go to the dictionary, English dictionary, you can find the word yoga. Dharma, you can find it in the English dictionary. Karma, you can find those in English dictionary. Why? It's a universally people are using this word. So what is dharma according to your realization? There's a lots of definition for the dharma. How do you define yourself this word dharma? I was thinking, questioning about it recently. When you hear the word dharma, yeah?
I associate karma.
Yeah, dharma and karma, okay, there's a connection. But when you hear the word dharma, how do you define to yourself? Teaching or wisdom is a good one.
A tool to use.
Okay, tool to use. Okay. Okay, mindfulness. That's great. Okay, all good. So, I found you know, I realized a good word, you know, I said the dharma, there's a whole book written about the word dharma, explaining the dharma, okay? There is a one meaning from the deep Buddhist teaching for the dharma is the way it is. Nature, or the way it is. I really like that explanation. Dharma is the nature, the way it is. So, if you don't understand way it is, whatever activities you are doing, no result in this spiritual journey. So, there is another word always in the Buddhist community, even the yoga community they are using, the word Sangha. Oh, you know, we are the Blue Lotus Sangha. We are the Sangha members of, you know, this and that. What is the Sangha? Common general explanation? Bhikkhuni? Community. Community. That's what we say, the community. I think that we are using this word Sangha in a very low explanation. Which is, you know, okay, that's a, you know, good meaning, you know, this community. So the real deep meaning of the word Sangha is become common, become we. We come because we exist because of what? The word, the pronouns, right? It's called the pronouns. We is a pronouns. W-E is a pronouns, right? English teacher?
Yes,
it's a pronoun. That we pronouns exist because of what pronouns? Huh?
You and I.
You?
You and I.
Okay, because we exist because of I. Okay, ego. Okay? So, the community, the Sangha means absence of I. Make sense now? The Sangha means not just community. We have drinking community. We have party community. You know, we have different communities. This is opposite of we. No, opposite of I. When we say I, that means we are separating. So when we are practicing meditation, what is our goal? Abandoning ego, or how to become we, not to become I. So when you become, we can talk later, when you become I, all the problems are coming. Now I'm asking you how you are going to become a Sangha member. If you want to become a Sangha member, what you have to do now? You have to work so hard to dissolve this word, I, then we become we. We become common. So when we have I, always we have problems. Do you see? When you have I, always you become a problem. Now think about our country, my family, my dog, my children. My body, I call I, my, and mine syndrome. When we have this syndrome, what you are creating? Pain, suffering, lamentation, sadness, and worries. Now, what I can see, the people who come to meditation practice, spiritual practice, they don't work on that. They don't want to work on that. Why? When you walk on our ego, we get scared. Then what we are doing, we are sugarcoating things. Monks know how to do very well too. You know, I did many years, you know, sugarcoating and give it, you know, like then easily you can swallow. Now I am thinking, I don't like those sugarcoating things anymore. But I want to see the real problem, real matter, what is the cause, what is happening in my mind, what is the problem. Dig into those problems and find the solution. So when I was in Greece, you know, last week, 2 weeks ago, so the last day, you know, the before people leave, the kind of people going around and little kind of partying kind of feeling. So we all are sitting in one table in the evening. That night, people are kind of, some people are drinking wine. You know, like when we are sitting around the whole table, I am in front of them too. Other side, the one lady took a picture. Then she was saying, Bhante, this picture is so funny. The bottle of wine exactly in front of you. That means she's a joker. She said, I can blackmail you. You know, if people love me and, you know, you're very close with me and, you know, now I can blackmail you. You know, look, now, you know, you look like a drinking wine. In that moment, I was thinking, then she asked me, if I do that, you know, I'm not going to do it. If I, you know, use this picture for something to hurt you or make people crazy about you or get upset about you, how do you feel? I said, doesn't matter for me. and then later I was thinking to myself, why I said that? I said, if you are using this picture, go and post on the Facebook or something like that. Now Bhante is drinking or something like that. If people do that, I said, doesn't matter for me. Then that moment, she said, I cannot understand what you said. I said, maybe it is too big for you to understand it. Then later we sit down and talk about it. I said, if you ask me this question like 10 years ago, I will get really upset. Maybe I can get mad with you. Maybe I grab your phone and delete the picture. I said, for me now, it's not a big deal. Why? It is not my problem. Now, you know, right after that, that it is not my problem, become always people using that word and joking. Whatever people say, oh, that's not my problem, but that's what Bhante said. So yes, that's not my problem. Why I create my problem? It's become mine. Does it make sense? Why if she make that picture on the Facebook, if I am upset about it, why are you upset? Why I get mad? Because I am believing something about me. Who I am. My identity. My name. My fame. What I build. My name. Then that night everybody become like a big talk about this. I said, right now, this is how I feel. I don't have things to lose. I don't have things to gain. I don't want anybody's appreciation. I don't want anybody's, you know, fame and grateful. I'm tired being in that level. So then they said, oh, maybe you are enlightened. I said, no, I'm not enlightened. Believe me, I'm not enlightened, but I can see the problem. Then I realize I don't want to go those back and forth. If somebody say that you are doing great, I just smile, thank you. If somebody say you are mean or rude, I say, okay, that's thank you. That's not my problem. That's their problem. So my point is, work on that root. Root is the ego. Until you work on that root, practicing your daily meditation, coming to Blue Lotus, another 15 years, you are the same person. So then one day, you become so free. No problems. When you're so free, then you become a good actor. That's how I call myself now. I'm a good actor now. I can go to Hollywood, no problem. I can act. I can act how to be in the world. Otherwise, I'm kicked out. Why? Thousands of millions of people in this world, if I am not act normal according to their beliefs, they are going to crucify me, kill me. You know, it makes sense now? So after I having that wisdom, now I know how to act in the world according to their normal level. But when you practice, your mind is a different level, but you are living in the different levels in the society. Otherwise, you cannot live in the society. Now think of there's a young men and women here. You know, maybe you have a different lifestyle in the world. What you are doing is great. You can practice and meditate, but when you go among your friends, you can act really well with them. So sometimes people, you know, when we are in out of country, so most of people who went to Greece, they never met me. They were so worrying, oh my God, this retreat Buddhist monk is coming, you know, how we are going to behave, and all those things, they are making whole big judgment about it, and so worrying. Right after they meet me, within 30 minutes, they said, you are crazy. Because their whole belief system about who I am is changed. Why? I know how to play the game. Because what I did, being in that society, I quickly adapt into that society, otherwise I cannot function. Being in them, being with them in their society, then I try to rise above that mud, I call the mud or garbage, and then being in that mud with them, I'm talking about something quality, powerful. Then people love me more. Then end of the day, people are crying and, you know, sad, very difficult to leave, and some people already coming September to here to do a retreat with me. All those things happen. But even that, it doesn't matter for me. Now what I'm asking you today, how you are going to become a Sangha member? It's clear now? Just calling I'm a Sangha member of the Blue Lotus Temple doesn't make any sense. Until you work on your ego, you are not becoming a Sangha member. You become a path, you become to that, you know, the journey. Then what will happen when you become a real, true Sangha member, after you are reducing your ego, then you become Dharma. What is the Dharma? The way it is. You just live in this world, you are smiling, you are happy, the whole world is going up and down, you are totally fine. So while I was in Greece, most beautiful, amazing place I ever seen in my entire life, in a Santorini in Greece, is so beautiful. It is overwhelming for my eyes looking at it, that beauty, nature. Second day, being in the retreat, first day, I heard the news what happened in Sri Lanka. Now think about emotionally. You know, because I thinking about my country, my people, what happened, the children lost parents, and all those drama going on in my head. And same time, I have to teach about peace 7 days. So now people are so concerned about me, how I feel about it. I said, I'm concerned. Then people said, you want to go home? I said, no, going home, I cannot do much. Because the problem happening everywhere in the world, it is a world matter now. So that night I realized, only thing I can do, I want to become a good Sangha member. I want to live my life with less ego, less expectation, otherwise world is too big for me to focus, too much happening around the world. All the negative things happening around the world, if I'm going back and forth in this game, how I'm going to enjoy my life? Now, my position and your position, be kind to yourself, do good things to yourself, you know, eliminate that ego little by little, and become a free person. If you cannot be free from yourself, all your concept and ideas, then you cannot enjoy this life. Sometimes people asking me, are you a Buddhist monk? Then I have to say yes. Then people know about the Buddhist background. Then they ask, are you a Theravada Buddhist monk? Then I have to say, that's my beginning. That's how I answer. That's how I started my journey. Then sometime way people, way I'm doing things in my life, sometime people are asking, are you a Mahayana monk? Act like a Theravada monk. So then I realize all those dharmas is the concept of the mind. So me now, my identity, my name, my beginning, my journey now, my journey in future doesn't matter. What is important now, how you live your life now. Less ego, joyful, every event you are doing, enjoying, you are, smiling to each person. Just enjoy wherever you are. So then I realize, if I have something to hold and gain and or lose, I am always in trouble. So what I have to do now, I have to separate myself from that concept of duality. This makes sense? Concept of duality, because always we are living a two, back and forth. So what I'm suggesting you, break both, lose those two, both concepts, and walk away from both. Then just live your life. If somebody says something good, just be with that. Somebody says something bad, just be with that. Why? Both will change. That's what we call the Dharma. Any questions? Yeah?
Is it safe to say that duality is the opposite of Dharma?
Yes, perfect. Duality is the opposite of the Dharma. It's very, I think, now think about all our life going, bouncing back and forth, this duality. It is exhausting and tired. Anything else?
The reason we should meditate is to discipline ourselves. We discipline the body, we discipline the mind, and that allows us to then get to a calmer state, and the soul will appear.
Mm-hmm.
But if you don't want to think that this path isn't a path of discipline, you're sadly mistaken.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that discipline is good, but make sure why we are making that discipline, to understand that true nature of the existence, which is why we are doing that, dissolve that the idea, the concept of self. Until you attach into that concept, always the problem keep coming. So, in the society, there are lots of people have discipline. They are very well disciplined, well behave, and lots of good manners. But when we are dealing with those people, that discipline is not going to their deeper state of mind. There's no connection sometimes. But discipline is a good thing. Many people get into that level of the discipline practicing meditation. Then they are enjoying that state of mind, having little fun there. So we have to get up and go and work on that other part of the life.
I've also found that, yes, discipline alone is a poor existence.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
you
exactly.
You must foster devotion.
Mm-hmm.
Without the love for the cosmic beloved, you're leading a very sad life.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You should do everything to nurture that.
Mm-hmm. Any other questions? Any ideas? Or confusing? Yeah. So I know whatever I said today, maybe it just feel right, but it's very difficult to digest. But just go home with that mindset. Just live your life with this idea. Walk and, remember why Buddha's coming to the world, because of pain. Why saints are coming to the world? Because of pain. There is no pain, there is no Buddhas. There is no pain, there is no enlightenment. All those good things happening because of that. So whatever you are going through, rough time in your life, don't look at it as a negative and creating more negative into that experience. So when you see something difficult in your life, please feel yourself, I am so close to the enlightenment. That's why I'm going through this rough time. Otherwise, all those negative experiences, people creating more negativity, more suffering, more pain into their life. So use that pain and negativity, difficulties and challenges, whatever it is, to bring your life to close to that Buddha nature or real nature of life. So then you can enjoy, you know, just being in this existence until you attain to enlightenment. Okay, so thank you so much. And this evening, I hope to see you again Saturday. And next Saturday, not this, 18, we have annual Buddha Day celebration. So please bring your family, friends, children, whoever, no limits. Bring everybody, then we have parade. So let's enjoy our annual family event.